Number one, four things occurred in the world. One is creation of the world, and the second thing is evolution of living, that is living beings like life. Third thing is evolution of human species. Fourth thing is evolution of civilization. First the universe was created, then life was evolved, then human beings they evolved, then the fourth thing is civilization, they are civilized. These four things are very much mechanical and accidental in modern science. So when everything is, how universe was formed by a Big Bang conjecture, how did it occur by means of an explosion, primordial cosmosynthesis, Riemannian geometry, Weyra geometry, hot and cold dark matter, black holes, everything that deals with a particular stage, beyond which it is known as accidental explosion. How life was formed, there was a droplet of protoplasm which accidentally formed out of some other special combination in the astral surface, where the droplet has fallen down, and by means of an instigatory consciousness that is assembled by means of an accidental phenomenon, that developed into amoeba, paramecium, then annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, platyhelminthes, echinodermatous. This is the modern science. Whereas we designed, the world was created for a purpose by a god. It is created by an intelligent person. It has rules and regulations. It has some ethics or order of living. If something is accidental, you can live like anything. If something is accidental, how you will have systematism, principalism and precision in your accidental system? So we believe this civilization is a predestined divine plan. Evolution is a divine connection, satya sankalpa. Evolution of life, it is by means of the theogenesis, but is the will of God. And the whole universe was created as a substratum for to organize ourselves and liberate ourselves, which is a provided divine opportunity that is offered by the divine munificence. So by munificence, by clemential shower, by means of his magnanimity, by means of his cravingness to uplift us and to give us liberation, God has created everything. So if you understand everything as a proper design, purposeful design, intellectual design, perfect and precise design, then you get everything, perfection, precise, modulation, self-systematization, everything will naturally come. That is why the accidental science theory has resulted in all accidents. Cosmic accident, traffic accident, global accident, everywhere there is an accident in each and every unit of science. So we have to understand this major thing. It is a basic substratum of life. And one more thing I want to say, I have to just quote because of lack of time. There are few issues of our culture we have to explain. Idolatry. The kafirs who have been mentioned in that Middle East countries are entirely different from us. Those who are assuming forms for God, for their facility is different from. We believe that God, out of their mercy, they occupy some forms because to facilitate our dhyana. In our system of idolatry or archavatara, we say that God, out of his merciful wish, he simplifies himself so that he is accessible to us. So idolatry is an issue in our things. Then animal sacrifice is a problem. Transmigration or continuity of birth is a problem. God is even born in the world, incarnation, that is an issue. Then adoration. God is treated as a human and human is worshipped as God. This is adoration. God is given food, cloth, everything. That is the human form of adoration of God. And great people in other cultures, they don't worship people. Acharyas and Bhagavatas, devotees and preceptors, they worship. It is adoration principle. So transmigration and also incarnation and adoration. Then animal sacrifices in rituals. Then the caste system of the society. These other issues, you have to contact in Vishwadhyaya Kendra. Separate seminars wherein by, if there are three possibilities. If they are time bounded, we can make it obsolete. If we are interpretation bounded, then we can give the real interpretation and say that these things are misinterpreted. Even if they are exploitations of the society and interpolations, we can say that they don't reflect the real Vedic society, they are interpolation by the successors. There are three philosophies. One is the interpolation possibility, second is the proper interpretation possibility, and the third thing is to consider that it is time bounded, kala tita, that it is obsolete. So we have to create in the adhyayana various sources of knowledge. And coming to the practical and concluding session, what we want to know is, number one, we are having three issues. One is the conversion issue, second is the invasion issue, and the third thing is placement issue. There are two things. We cannot prevent in a democratic society, that too in the pseudo-secular society, it is very difficult to replace somebody or to organize something different. Everybody is emerging in good standards. Now if you see, there is a report in which judiciaries, ruling party, bureaucrats, everybody, they are representations from the Dushta Chatushtaya, which Hanuman Chaudhary, he is from Pragya Bharati, he used to say in Mahabharata there is Dushta Chatushtaya. That is Dushasana, Duryodhana, Karna and Shakuni. they were collectively known as Dushta Chatushtaya. He told the same thing as the first Dushta is M. Macaulay, Lord Macaulay. Second M is Muslim. Third M is missionary. Fourth M is Marxism. These four things have been collectively given a name by Hanuman Chaudhary as Dushta Chatushtaya. So in this pseudo-secular society, wherein by in the pretext of minority protection means it is only protecting minority. It does not mean that minority is also protected. The real definition for minority protection is wherever there is a possibility for two things. The minority being disintegrated, collapsed, economically deprived, they should be weak. The majority being so atrocious and integrated, there is a possibility of insecurity or possibility for some sort of collapse and collision between the majority and minority. It should be administered, this drug should be administered only in the area where there is predominance of the majority, where there is a debilitation for minority like Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, etc. It can be minority protection should be made. And in some area where the majority is totally disintegrated, the minority is hyper potentialized and immigrated, we have to enact only the majority protection act, not the minority protection act. So like that, in this society, growing society like this, only possibility is placement. That too we have to fight with the reservation and see that we are placed in merit. Most of the people in the judiciary, either they are direct representatives of this four Chatushtaya or they are supporters directly or indirectly of them. The whole industry, I am not joking, in all bureaucratic services, in judicial services and in media services, if you do a research, most of the media services like Times, then Aajtak, NDTV, most of the things, most of the journalists are prepared by Jawaharlal Nehru University. Wonderful, that's what I'm saying. We have to create some sort of merit status, IAS training institute, journalism training institute, some sort of training institute for bureaucratic placement, political placement, industrial placement, then social animators placement, NGO placement. Everybody, they have a design. Like Ravana came in the form of sannyasi, so that there will be a credibility and accountability. Like that, he has clearly told about NGOs. Most of the NGOs, instead of directly entering into some set of arms and ammunition, transfer, immoral trafficking, drug trafficking, then smuggling, and also conversion in the pretext of social service by means of creating a pseudo-structural tears in their eyes and creating a pretextual method of pretentious praying and healing systems, it is being done by the society. So these NGOs, most of the people, they have only two things. One thing is infiltration. And the second thing is conversion. Infiltration by debilitating the society, the social security and the social economy by means of doing all the malicious and heinous crimes in the society. So NGOs, proper NGOs, proper media people, proper judiciaries, proper bureaucrats, silently we have to permeate like Chanakya instructed Chandragupta. Chandragupta immediately attacked the center and he was subjected to a successful failure. At that time there was a story told to me, and these two people, they have been taking some food. Dosha, they have been taking dosha in a village hut due to their heavy appetite. At the time Chandragupta, due to this over enthusiasm or his killing appetite, he pinched some dosha from the center. Then that old lady, it seems that she has advised, you see, you should start from this surroundings. Gradually when you have been taking this surroundings inside, gradually the heat will be mitigated so that you can approach the center. What she has expressed in the dosha technology, he has understood his dosha. From that dosa he has got the knowledge about his dosha. Then he has created first border attacking, creating infrastructure inside, slow penetration, then obtaining some techniques and tacticalities of intelligence and propaganda mechanism. Gradually he entered inside. Like that we should Vishwa Dhyana Kendra. It is not only talking and discussing, we have to establish training centers by which shining stars of future media industry, productive industrial technology, science, academicians, everybody should be incubated from that, so that we can have a replacement. Because we cannot stop them growing, but we can create a big line by which they can be belittled. That is the only immediate possibility we are having, that number one. Number two, apart from this thing, conversion is a problem. I told you in seminar, it is very wonderful, I want to say it in a simple brevity. Whenever you change the attire and attitude, everything will be gradually changing. That's what I told you. If you just convert yourself from a tough to a crap, immediately you will lose the integrity of your spiritual will. It starts with a dress, then it comes into design, then it comes to demeanor, then it comes into discipline, then characteristic infiltration and fusion will occur. You will lose integrity, or you will lose your approach or determination with your own culture. So your dress, your language, if you talk in English, I am also talking in English, it is a process by which Rama has made